attempt to do this while I'm driving here. What's up? Jeez, it's been a minute, I think. I don't think I've really posted anything in the past month. I think the last thing that I posted was Let's Go Brandon. I think that's the cake that it was. It was just a little demo. I have one demo left, and it is a fish cake, and I'm pretty sure it's a 350-gram redfish. It's redfish, bluefish, nuts. Yeah, something like that. It's the Dr. Seuss little fish cake or something like that. And Alex basically made me buy it a long time ago. Or no, he bought it. Yeah, that's right. I told him there's no way in hell I would buy that, so he bought it. That's the only demo I have left in the bank right now. So a little bit of news, basically. I started my own venture and stuff like that. I'm trying to keep up on how I do business and everything like that, because I need to make sure my bills are paid, because the pennies that I make off of every single video don't exactly pay for my mortgage or my little monster to eat. So I just wanted to reach out to you guys and say what a year it has been from, last year this time, like July 3rd going into the 4th. I mean, I look at it as such a blessing that I've been able to grow, just this incredible community of people and pyros that just keep coming together night in and night out. And it's so crazy to me because I never really thought it could actually hit that benchmark as much as it has. And I mean, a huge thing for me is the views, the subscribers. You could have a video go viral. And by viral, I mean like 50,000 views in like a couple hours or something like that. That's what I think viral means. You could have a video go viral and get a bunch of loose subscribers is what I'll call them. But you'll never actually have a solid fan base to where your channel is like performing the way it needs to perform and everything like that. So whereas someone out there could have 15,000 subscribers or something like that, and they would only be, in it to watch a couple videos here and there or something like that. But if you post like a fountain video or something like that, they're the first persons not to click on it. They don't really care about that type of stuff, which is fine. Everyone has their own niche. They only want to watch certain things and do certain things. That's fine. I don't care. I think even negative criticism is still great because I get some sort of reaction out of it. So even when people tell me I suck or I do this, I do that, or I'm no better than some street pyro that goes and lights something off and sets his neighbor's house on fire, that's fine. I don't care because I know I never set nothing on fire. I try to be safe with everything I do. My number one goal is to hit 1 million views because that's very important to me, because that means the channel that I dreamt about, 10 plus years ago and decided to start out of the blue off of a whim, got that many people to look at it. That's a big deal for me. By the end of today, we'll probably be at 600,000, right? Like 590,000. And I basically was flabbergasted when I saw that number. It's a big deal for me because, I could get a crap ton of subscribers and stuff like that, but it's the views for me that really say, even if they don't want to subscribe, they still clicked on it. They still took a look. They still wanted to see what we were doing and what we're about and how we do things. And I've been told countless times that my intros and outros are fantastic, that they love the logo, that they love, the mystique that I've created behind the Black Hawk helicopter and everything like that. The Black Hawk Hilo is literally one of the most menacing things I've ever seen in my whole entire life. And I've only seen one Black Hawk helicopter. And it was the coolest freaking thing. Everyone's just like, why'd you choose the helicopter? It's like, are you ex-military? It's like, no, I'm not. But I have plenty of friends and family that are military, plenty of friends and family that are police officers, Blue Line, anything like that, firefighters, all that fun stuff. So I respect anything and everything that resembles brothers and sisters fighting in arms, and also, you know, the ones that aren't exactly on the front lines, because that's important. But the Black Hawk Helo is the most menacing thing I've ever seen, and I just thought, you know, for that to be a face of something, that would be so freaking cool. And that's kind of how that happened. But getting off topic of what I wanted to talk about, the number one thing I'm aiming to do is grow. And I think we've definitely accomplished that this year. We've gotten 1,100 subscribers and probably over another 125,000 views, which is mental, because I feel like I haven't done enough for you guys, and guys and girls. I feel like I don't deserve that, especially because I haven't done the store tours this year. I haven't really gone out of my way to get a lot of stuff done for you guys that I really would have liked to. And that's not me being like dramatic or, you know, trying to say that, you know, I'm not worthy or anything like that. I know I've done a lot of stuff in the past that's still performing well, and a lot of people are coming forward saying that they still appreciated the fact that I did do the store tours and stuff like that at the Superstore and all that other fun stuff. But I still feel like if I'm not actively posting and stuff like that, that it hurts. You know, because the people that actually do watch and do pay attention, they're looking for something out of me and they don't get nothing. So trust me, I hear you, and I definitely want to be more involved, but right now it's just tight. So I'm trying to make sure that I can be the best father I can be, best husband I can be, best, you know, business owner I could be, I guess, while also trying to keep my hobbies in line. It's tough. So I just wanted to take the minute and or 7 minutes to kind of try to relay that information and what I have planned. Because next year, I definitely want to follow through on a lot of stuff, and it's going to be fun, and I can't wait. The big one being getting a lot more interaction out of Pyros and a lot more involvement. So by involvement, I mean getting... You know, I posted this on the community tab just to see kind of how people would react to it and everything like that. And I got a bunch of likes and everything, but it's something I want to see in comments. I want to see how I could make the system better, how I could do it better. And that being challenges. There are tens of thousands of pyro channels out there. I want to know every single one of them. I want to know every single one of them. I want to know their names. I want to know how they do pyrotechnics, how they handle pyrotechnics, how they learned, how they, maybe they have connections that I don't have or anything like that. That's not the point. The point is I want to do a challenge and I want to see if I can beat them. I want to see if I could do like, say, a $500 challenge. Who could put on the best show for $500? You know, because $500 is like the median budget right now if you want to get anything. Because freaking fireworks are so outlandish right now. You can still get a good amount for $500, I feel like. But I also want to do it to where we keep the tried true stuff out of it. So the stuff that's supposed to be shush-shush and, you know, make sure that it's kind of out of it completely to where it's all consumer. It's every single bit of consumer, name brand, Window Raccoon, you know, anything under the sun as far as just keeping it only stuff that anyone can really buy without having a plug or whatever the hell you want to call it. You know, if I could do that, I feel like that would be a lot of fun, because that would actually give a diverse opinion to people that don't just care about anything OL or anything that's hot or anything that, you know, everyone needs to see all the time. It's like, oh, what's this do? What's that do? It does the same damn thing as the cake that was the same as it that just got rewrapped. Like, it is getting out of control how much people care about that type of crap. And it's just, it's kind of numb to me because maybe I just don't care as much. Like, I'll post it up and get it out there because I want to see what it does and I like seeing what they do. But at the same time, I like going back to the simple things where it's just like I get a nice cake that has just amazing effects, and I like color. I like the nice effects. I like a nice spread. I love fan cakes. And my Achilles heel is falling leaves or willows or anything like that, like how a lot of other people's are. You know, does a cake go boom, bam, and everything like that? Yeah, sure, that's great. But I don't need sky puke. I want something that's nicely spaced. I want something that's nice, has a beautiful pattern and brilliant, freaking brilliant, vibrant colors. Because not all cakes have that. You know, you could fill a cake with crackle and everyone's going to be like, oh, wow, that was awesome. I look at it and it's like, ugh. You know, I can't see having something like that and being like, this is going to be the bee's knees. This is going to be fantastic. I care about a lot of different other things, which is great, because it gives me this type of idea to where I can say, hey, what if I were to do something to where it's like all you can get is $500 worth of fireworks, but you can't do anything of the unsung stuff that I don't even want to mention because the freaking video gets flagged. But, you know, keep it to where it's consumer. Keep it to where it's all the stuff that anyone can get and go from there, you know? And who could put on the best show and then let you guys vote, you know? Versus, you know, I don't know. It could be someone with 50-something thousand subscribers. Could be someone with freaking, you know, 200 subscribers. I don't care. Because here's the thing. Someone that has 200 subs could know a lot more than me. They could know a lot more than someone else that has like 30,000 subs. You know, like those type of people are the unsung heroes of the industry. Because I was told this by someone a long time ago that you can either be a YouTuber or a pyro. You can't be both. And I told them in the moment that I disagree. But now I'm starting to see it from face value where he's kind of right. Because if you want to be a pyro, you want to be in it. You want to be about it. You want to be thinking about it. You're not looking to post stuff and do stuff like, you know what I mean? You're not actually trying to take videos and stuff like that. You're trying to just further your knowledge in the industry. And if you're over there posting videos and not necessarily getting in for clout or anything like that, that's essentially what it is. It's stroking an ego. If you're doing anything like that, you're not exactly embracing what it really means to be a pyro. And 20 years ago, I had 2 packs of firecrackers and some fountains. And I was 11 years old and I was on top of the world. You could not stop me. You know, I look on that now and it's like, man, what happened in 20 years to where I look at what I have now and it's just like, I wish I could go back. You know, because being a pyro then is not what it means to be a pyro now. And a lot of the older guys will probably agree with me on that. And a lot of the younger guys will probably be like, well, you don't know anything. It's fine. I don't care. Everyone can have an opinion. Everyone can tell me I'm wrong. You can tell me I'm fat. Tell me my beard is weird. I don't care. There's a lot of things in life that are worth living. And being a pyro was one of the best parts about life for so long. Because not only did you have someone across the street that thought that they could be louder than you, but you also had someone in the next neighborhood that was just like, were you the one that was blowing that stuff off? It's like, yeah, it's like, let me get some of that. You know, it was more of a community than it is now. Now it's just a bunch of thugs running around thinking they got the loudest stuff. And, you know, that's how people get hurt. But, you know, what I want to do is I want to involve as many people as possible because I want it to be a community again. I want it to be something that everyone can kind of be proud of again. And that's why with me having this new business venture and everything like that, I'm now going to have time to embrace these shows, these expos and everything like that. Like, I want to hit up PGI. I want to hit up Skywars. I want to go to CobraCon. I want to go to all these different things across the board because I never had time for them before. I want to do them now, you know, while I can absorb as much knowledge as I can from these older guys that have just had years and years and years of experience on me to where I can really utilize that to what I post and what I do. Because I feel like if you're not genuine about what you do from start to finish, you're no better than all these street thugs and everything else like that that have just been absolutely annihilating the community. Yeah, with that being said, I would love to get everyone's opinions, to get everyone's thoughts on the matter, to get, you know, a wholesome topic on what they think could be fun. Like, I want to do, like, rocket challenges. I want to do, you know, like, overall, like, just shells. Like, okay, only spend $200 on only shells. You know, who can do the longest shell? And I mean, like, you can't do, like, only, like, short fuse, or not short fuse, like, long fuse or anything like that. You know what I mean? Like, you got to have it look nice. Or who can do the nicest show with, like, a 24-pack of shells? You know, like, there's certain things. I could word it a million different ways. Like, you could do $500 or something like that on only fan cakes, or $250 who could put on the best show with just 200 grams. Anything across the board you can think of, you can do in that element. And then obviously the winner would get bragging rights and, you know, all that other fun stuff. But, you know, the winner also has to now then choose the next challenge. You know, here's the next challenge. I challenge so-and-so to this and so-and-so to this. And you got to do it by this date or anything. You know, like, it could be a huge thing and it could be a lot of fun for everybody. So I want to try and see that through more than anything. You guys tell me if you think that would be fun. If you think that's something you'd definitely click on. If you think that that's something that could help out your channel. If you're a channel that has 200 subs and you want to do something with me or something with any other Chicago pyro or anything like that, tell me. Reach out to me. I got a Facebook. I got an Instagram. I got, you know, you can, if you want to comment on something on YouTube, I'll respond. If you want to do something fun like that, let me know. I'd love to meet up with you. I'd love to talk with you about it. I'd love to see if we can set something up to where you're involved. You know, it's not about getting everything set up to where I'm on the top of a mountain. It's on to where it's like, we can get everything together the right way the first time. Yeah, I think that's all I got to say about it. Jeez, I've been talking way too long. Sorry, I just came from Indiana, so I'm on my way home. So, I just wanted to say again, you know, thank you guys so much. This has just been one hell of a year. It's been a lot of fun kind of seeing how everyone's been doing their shows. And we've had a lot of different requests to go back to different places that I didn't think I would be actually getting, to be honest. So that'll probably be on the docket for in the fall. A lot of new products coming out and stuff like that. Working on a bunch of different companies to come out with my own cake and everything like that, or conspiring to do my own cakes and everything. So definitely a lot of stuff coming. Definitely a lot of stuff that I can't wait to be involved in. But yeah, right now my focus is kind of making sure the bills are paid. But as far as that goes, I just really wanted to say thank you guys so much. If you watch this video all the way through, I mean, you're the real MVP. If you don't watch it all the way through and just a fat guy rambling in a truck, that's fine too. If you are one of the OG Blackhawk pyros, you are literally the reasons why I do the things that I do. If you're new, welcome to the shit show. I honestly can't thank you guys enough. This has been one hell of a ride, one hell of a year. You know, on the road to 4,000, obviously, but really on the road to a million, because you know, I don't want this train to stop. I want to keep pushing. I want to keep having fun. I want to get everyone involved. I want everyone to have fun. I want everyone to be the best version of themselves, because it is a crappy saying, but life is way too short, and it is. And I think if we can all get together, we can all have fun. That's the number one goal for me. So thank you guys again so much. If you're still around right now, it's a great video. So I'll talk to you guys all soon, and wait to see what we got in store. It's going to be a fun one.